and a very fuck all Monday morning to you too. Welcome to the first episode of the Metal Sphere vlog, and I'm your host Pratika. The show is brought to you by me. I'm wearing the sexy Big 6ix9ine t-shirt. Big 6ix9ine was India's first two-day heavy metal festival, offering a well-curated, full-scale festival experience, and I'm still mourning over the fact that it's over. This show is only about the metal scene in India. In this episode, I will talk to you about a few highlights in the Indian metal scene like Cultfest, Planet Radio City's new 24/7 metal radio station, the Downtrodden's Inner Sanctum, and much more. I will also head to Borivali and give you a sneak peek into the new Albatross album Fear of the Skies, scheduled to release very, very soon. I'll be going to engineer Ashwin Shilian's lair, not Dr. Hex's, and talking to the band themselves. We'll listen to some new material while we're there. Later in the episode, I will go to Cult Lounge's Rock and Roll Night, a new venue that has just opened up to metal gigs. Their first metal gig took place on the 29th of March. The gig featured Swedish metal band Mindshift, Mumbai heavy metal band Hellwind, who are back after over a year and a half of break time, traditional heavy metal band Albatross, who played some favourites with a few guests, and a Guns N' Roses tribute band called Guns Reloading. We have Cultfest happening this weekend. The gig will take place this Saturday on the 11th of April at Manfo Convention Center, Bangalore. The lineup features US death metal veterans, the mighty Cannibal Corpse, and deathcore flag bearer Suicide Silence. Also part of the lineup is Shillong's three-piece death metal powerhouse Plague Throat and Pune Boys Abraxas. A single opening slot will be awarded to the winner from the Cultfest pre-gig party out of 8 bands selected from all over the country. The pre-gig will take place on Thursday, the 9th of April at Indigo Music Bar, Koramangala, Bangalore. The bands selected to play at the pre-gig are Psychorax from Darjeeling, Evil Conscience and Obscure Defilement from Kolkata, Pyramids from New Delhi, Bestial Murder from Kochi, Orion from Mumbai, Darkhelm from Pune and Before the Holocaust from Chennai. For more information, visit www.cultfest.in. Planet Radio City now has a metal radio station and they are streaming Indian metal 24/7. All you have to do is log on to www.planetradiocity.com/internet/radiocity-metal, or they've also added Radio City Metal to the Planet Radio City app, which you can download from the App Store or Google Play. The Downtrodden's are set to play in Cairo, Egypt, headlining the Wakin Metal Battle Middle East Final along with Egyptian bands Crescent and Nathir on the 24th of this month. Bangalore metal band Inner Sanctum have just played Inferno Metal Festival in Norway, being one of the many Indian metal bands to have played the festival. Inner Sanctum will be releasing their album Legions Awake on the 26th of April at Counterculture in Bangalore. So far, the other bands playing the gig are Demonic Resurrection and Plague Throat. My sources in Kolkata are telling me that the Kolkata Death Fest is tentatively scheduled to take place in August with an international headliner and will be supported by a few death metal bands from Kolkata itself and other states. Last time, KDF saw the brutal Defiled from Japan headlining the show, supported by bands from Kolkata and Darjeeling. Domination the Death Fest, India's first extreme metal fest, is back. The gig will take place on the 16th of May at Terrace by Techies in Karkhana, Hyderabad. The bands playing this edition of DDF are Demonic Resurrection, Primitive and Wild Anxiety from Mumbai, Threnody and Grosty from Bangalore, and Purgation Inc. from Kolkata. For more information on the history of Death Fest, visit my fucking blog. Heathen Beast is back. That's it. Their Make My Merch campaign was also successful, selling over the target of 20 t-shirts. You can head over and buy your t-shirt too. The design is titled Bakras to the Slaughter and the campaign ends on the 18th of April. It's time to go to Borivali and see what's been up with Albatross.
Hey, almost 4 years in the making. We have been recording for 2 years almost. So I mean, we are so relieved we are done right now. One question I get asked a lot is, who is Dr. Hex? And so I thought I'll make a fictional story about the whole concept. And what essentially happens here is, I mean, it starts off as your typical anti-establishment kind of album, and then you realize that there is more to it, there's a twist in the tale. So Dr. Hex, essentially in this part of the album, he's a corrupt politician. So, and we write a horror story based on that. And the second part of the album is something Jay came up with. We were playing this fest called Evolution in Bangalore. And as we are heading back, suddenly Jay exclaims, which is not something he does regularly, and he tells us this whole story of a circus that comes to town and of a giant Ferris wheel that reaches above the clouds, and how there have been a string of murders in that particular town, and how like this the architect of all those murders is this clown called Jugglehead. So I mean, we combined all of those elements and we came up with a story. That's pretty much it, both sides of the album.
I think Riju writes the song first, we come up with the story. And in this album, it was Jay's part 2. And after that, I think me and Nishit sit down and we come up with the theme of the song, like how we want it to be. This album, mainly Nishit has written, so most of the songs he did. But that's how it is. He comes up with the story, then we write the songs, and then we see what part goes well with the rest. And yeah, the song, it's pretty easy with us actually. Because
yeah.
we one song takes like one jam to just get the structure down.
And both of them have a very different style of actually composing music. So in the sense that when Vignesh writes a part, it's in a certain style, and Nishit's songwriting is like the polar opposite of that. So when, for example, when Nishit comes up with a riff, I tell Vignesh to come up with something like entirely different. And those twists and turns are what makes Albatross. Starting from the 31st of May, we have planned out a kind of a nationwide, not entirely nationwide, but Bombay, Bangalore and a few other cities, we can't tell you about it right now. But we're going to be visiting these cities, and basically there's going to be a tour, and we are going to be releasing this album on Transcending Obscurity India, a label owned by Kunal Choksi.
Who's not a school friend.
And there's also going to be merchandise. He's thought of something very cool for this album. The stories, because stories are such an integral part of our music, and not a lot of people know what the stories are. They're going to be like presented in a very different kind of format.
Yeah. There's definitely a change in sound, I feel. Like, Dinner Is You was completely different, and there's a lot of other influence coming into like this album, like a lot of Megadeth, a lot of Metallica, a lot of different old
Iron Maiden-ish
kind of vibe going on. Yeah, it's completely different than what it was before, so it's something really new from that.
Yeah, I mean, like any Albatross album, like, do not expect anything, it will be very different from what you expected.
I think this album, like, it happened for a reason. I mean, it took long to complete it, but maybe it all happened for the good. So, yeah, it was pretty good, and I developed a good rapport with the band. So, these guys, I mean, they have their day jobs, so they would only get Saturday, Sundays off, and either I was gigging or they were gigging. They used to gig like every alternate week or something, so it was quite impossible to fix recording dates, and I think that's one of the major reasons why it took so long to complete the whole thing. So they are awesome guys, like pretty chilled out, and it was never a problem, you know, like I would have gigs or they would have gigs, so we would keep cancelling or rebooking or whatever, and yeah, it was less of, I mean, I never had a feeling like I'm working, but it was more of like, you know, chilling out and having a good time and cracking all these lame jokes and all that shit.
Riju jokes.
Yeah, Riju jokes. He's in the band, so.
Well, the mastering process hasn't really begun, but I've been in on the mix through each revision, listening to the mixes as they shaped up, making suggestions. And the first thing I realized as I started listening to the material is how much more focused and mature and evolved the band's music sounds compared to the previous albums. Also, on a production level, it's such a huge step up from everything before it. All three guitar players have played really well, the songwriting is really good. The solos are amazing, and what's cool is that everyone in the band has a different style in terms of the lead playing. So when there are three solos in a song, it's so easy to pick them out, and they all present something completely new to the music. I mean, everyone knows what Nishit's style is like. Varun has a pretty different style in terms of what the band usually has. And Vignesh's style is pretty angular, you know, there's a lot of interesting turns in his solos. So that makes the lead guitar sound of things like very interesting, very varied, very fresh. The production also, what Ashwin's done with the mix is like on a whole other level, which is excellent. It really sounds very good, very professional, very clean, and very finished already, even though the mastering hasn't begun. I think it's, in terms of overall quality, going to knock the ball out of the park by Albatross's own standards, even.
Now for Rock and Roll Nights, it's gig time.
But people here enjoy music, and so do we. So it's so cool to come to a culture that's really, they really get into the music. Because in Sweden, especially Stockholm, everybody goes like this.
Yeah. So impress me.
Yeah. So when you come here and everybody goes, it's so much more fun. And
also, it's cool to find a common ground, even though we're hundreds of miles apart. You can always find a common ground in music. And the love for music, and that's really cool.
Hellwind actually pulling this whole shit back together, saying enough of fucking sitting around and not doing anything. So we said, let's just play, man. I mean, I don't know why the fuck we're waiting around. So bring this shit back together and let's tear up some more stages. 1.5 years later, we're back. And fuck yeah.
See, I got like Nipu Pani the moment I came here, so I was like, oh, nice hospitality.
What's extra special for Albatross tonight?
We are only playing covers, and the originals that we are playing are with people that we haven't jammed in like years. And so I mean, there's going to be a lot of friends who come on stage, and people who have been asking us to play like one cover per gig now will be happy because we'll be playing all our covers. That is true.
I'm playing guitars for one song, Uncle Sunny at the Tavern.
But that's with Albatross.
That's the song which I composed for Albatross.
That's awesome. Very nice. So why did you leave Albatross?
I had health issues. I already answered these questions. What the hell?
Have you answered these questions?
Yes, on Ask FM.
Oh yeah.
Ask.fm.
I've been asked to do. I've been asked to do a song that I've been really wanting to do with Albatross for a while. Called Uncle Sunny at the Tavern. Incidentally, the song was named on the concept of the album, of course, but then also a means of revenge that Riju used against me. It's a long story, you can ask him. But yeah, I'm doing that song. I've been meaning to do the song with them for a while. And it's happening finally.
blog under the same name, Metalsphere. You can check it out by simply visiting touchthismetalsphere.blogspot.in. There's so much going on in every part of the country, and I really want to bring all of this to the masses, but I can't possibly do everything myself. Tell me if you're organizing a gig, doing a college festival or music festival with a sick lineup, coming out with an EP or album, or just want to say hi and give me some feedback. Send in all of this to indian.metalsphere@gmail.com and let's do this together. If you like what you see, please subscribe to this channel on the link given below. Cheers and until next time.
Initially, it was supposed to be an EP and we only do EPs. It was then suddenly Kunal Choksi comes one day and he says, make a full length album. redo.
Why did everyone start laughing?